fellow Toastmasters and most welcome guests, I'd like to introduce you to someone today. This is Rio. She's a 9-year-old German Shepherd living a happy and healthy life with a loving family. But the truth is that Rio faced a really, really grim past. She was severely neglected. Authorities found her with a severe ear infection and wounds to her jaw and her ear. On top of that, her prior owner refused to seek professional medical attention. As a result, she found herself in a shelter and was fortunate enough to find a much promising and better owner. Fellow Toastmasters and most welcome guests, Rio is only one of the most fortunate cases. The truth is that there are several animals that spend most of their lives in these shelters, waiting to be adopted, waiting to be loved, even though they've suffered neglect, abuse, and traumatization. So today, I'd like to bring a call to action to educate you all about animal shelters and adoption. Inspire a seed of taking action for these voiceless animals, and maybe even convince some of you to adopt one of these furry creatures. Now, let's start with one of the most prominent benefits of adopting versus buying. Adopting a shelter pet is much cheaper than buying any animal. Adoption prices range from between $25 to $300, and this fee includes the cost of spraying, neutering, vaccinations, whereas buying a pet can extend over $1,000, and all those medical necessities are at the individual's own cost. So you're looking at pretty wallet-friendly price here. That's the explicit monetary term. Now in terms of implicit costs, when you adopt a pet, you're fighting against unethical breeders who force animals to breed in inhuman and unhabitable conditions. You can check that out for your own time and look at the graphic conditions in which they're raised. Overall, by adopting a pet, you're also saving some money and stopping society from progressing in these unethical businesses. Now you all may be thinking, well, if adoption is so cheap, a lot of pets might be adopted. But the truth is that 2.7 million animals are put down or simply killed in the US every year because these facilities lack resources, staffing, and commitment to care for the 6.5 million animals that enter the shelter each year. By adopting a pet, you're saving a life from euthanization. And it's really sad to consider that a lot of these pets end up there not because they're mean or they can't function in families, but rather the owners can't devote their time, money, and can't care for the pet. So adopting a pet really gives them a second chance at reconstructing their life. This is my favorite reason for adoption. You're going to be making a best friend when you adopt a shelter pet. As a general basis, all animals help humans psychologically, emotionally, and physically. They're found to reduce stress, they can detect heart attacks and other epileptic seizures in their owners, they make you more sociable, and they reduce blood pressure. Adopting a shelter pet has an added bonus because you're essentially nurturing a new life for this animal. It gives the owners a sense of fulfillment, a sense of purpose in your life. It's kind of like having a child. By adopting a pet, you not only give a new direction in the life of the animal, but the animal also gives you a new direction in your life. And you'll be making a loyal companion that will stand with you through the best of times and through the worst. So, in the end, shelter pets and adoption is more economical and stops unethical businesses. You'll save lives by avoiding euthanasia and gain a loyal companion along the way. You might think with these benefits, adoption is a pretty good thing, but unfortunately it's severely overlooked in our society because a lot of people want to go for the perfect breed or toy breed dog, which are only available through buying. But that's not the truth. If you put your time and effort into finding the right pet, there are several shelters across the GTA where you can go look at the pet, experience firsthand if it fits with you, and decide on whether you want to bring this creature home with you or not. The reason I brought this up is because it's the holiday season. It's the season of giving. And there's no better way to express this care for the season than giving a new life to someone. This can be through a simple donation, volunteering, and the very best, adopting a pet. So I request you all to go home today and consider animal adoption, charity work, and animal shelters as part of your holiday charity list. In the end, I hope you all find a friend in some way. Thank you.